Well, it wasn't just the magazine that was scared of that. The NBA itself and sports were afraid. Too many black players are going to turn white fans away. Not only was it our magazine who was afraid of that, endorsements. It was very common for the best African-American players not to get endorsements, while lesser white players did. You didn't want your product identified with the black player. You were afraid that that was going to scare, you know, some whites away from your product. So it was across the board. There was no question about it. There was
and Frank,
the fear,
Frank, you go a step further.
The fear of that.
If I can quote from your book, you write that given the existing journalistic mores at the time, a great many white reporters were something of default racist.
I think that's true. I think that we were going, all of us white folks, were going through a transformational period, and that we still retained with us, if reluctantly, and I think we were somewhat embarrassed, but nonetheless it was the case, so some residual racism that, thank the Lord, was passing by. I think one thing about being in sports, whether as an official or in my case as a journalist, is that you got to deal personally with black athletes, and then that might have changed your opinion. In fact, I think it did with a lot of sports writers.